it's a big group. But in an ideal situation, I would like to hope that they get a kind of rained out game against India and beat everyone else. And then you never know, they could be qualifying for the next phase of the World Cup. If you look at guys like Aaron Jones, who's a valuable part of the team, Stephen Taylor, a lot of responsibility is going to be on those guys' shoulders. And two of the guys that you mentioned now in Ali Khan and Corey Anderson. And let's not forget guys like Monang Patel, Nostus Kunjige. So they've got a couple of players that can do, but it's purely on the day, you know, in this format of the game.
With the upcoming T20 Men's ICC World Cup being played in the US and West Indies, and cricket on the rise in the US, the USA cricket team is looking to make their mark on the June 1st to 29th tournament. The inclusion of former New Zealand all-rounder Corey Anderson, who has experience of playing in 3 World Cups, and star bowler Ali Khan, who missed the US 4-0 win over Canada recently, is exciting news. Welcome to another edition of At The Wicket with myself, Cavalli Arnold, and our guest today is Dane Piedt. Welcome.
Hello, so how are you?
Welcome, Dane.
Thank you.
To have you.
Yeah, it's good to be here. Good to be here. Thanks for having me.
Yeah. With the squad named recently, right, what's your take on the squad and, you know, their chances in the tournament?
Yeah, I think they're definitely an underdog, without a shadow of a doubt. Having been a part of the system for a couple of years now, just seeing the guys develop and playing. Obviously, a lot of guys will feel unlucky. Guys like Ober Spinner, for example, he had a great run recently in the US. A bit unlucky. But at the end of the day, it's down to what the selectors chose. And if you look at guys like Aaron Jones, who's a valuable part of the team, Stephen Taylor, a lot of responsibility is going to be on those guys' shoulders. And two of the guys that you mentioned now in Ali Khan and Corey Anderson. And let's not forget guys like Monang Patel, Nostus Kunjige. So they've got a couple of players that can do, but it's purely on the day, you know, in this format of the game. It's purely on the day, and they will be eyeing, you know, games like Canada and Ireland trying to get over the line.
Yeah, most certainly I expect them to be looking at those games, as you just said, as marquee games to try and get those maximum points. And then you're in the group with the likes of India and Pakistan. It's always exciting when those two play.
Yeah.
But in terms of taking points off them, we know Pakistan can blow hot or cold.
Yes.
India's a powerhouse, but everyone can have a bad day.
Yeah, I know. That's the two marquee games that everybody's gonna look forward to. I mean, playing the India, and a majority of the squad having been born in India too, and a couple being born in Pakistan, that's going to be, you know, sort of, you know, trying to make an impression on their previously adopted or previous countries that they were born in. So they're going to try and make a name for themselves in the way that they handle the pressure situations within those games. And if they can get ahead of the game early on, you never quite know, you know, because conditions are going to be foreign to a lot of the players. If they're playing in the US. So it's going to be important just to set the tone early on. It's a big group, but in an ideal situation, I would like to hope that they get a kind of rained out game against India and beat everyone else. And then you never know, they could be qualifying for the next phase of the World Cup.
Yeah, and that would be exciting for US cricket. We'll get to that a little bit more later in terms of the impact on the whole Western, and not just say Western, let me say Northern, because Canada and US having that sort of World Cup. But let me just focus firstly on the inclusion of Corey Anderson and Ali Khan coming back into the team and what this will mean for the team in terms of the strategy and dynamics of the team for the World Cup.
Yeah, I mean, that comes with a wealth of experience. I mean, Ali Khan, having played in the CPL, he's played in the ILT 20. He's had a stint at the IPL with the Knight Riders. He signed the number one pick for the LA Knight Riders here in the US too. So, I mean, he's really made a name for himself in the T20 circuit. He's got a lot of experience having bowled to a lot of these powerhouse cricketers. And then if you look at, you know, Corey Anderson's record speaks for itself, you know, having broken the ODI record against the West Indies back in New Zealand many years ago. He's going to add a lot of power to that middle order, you know. And if he gets an innings of 90 or 55 balls in a game against one of the big teams, you never know, you know. It's always up to the big players having these situations. So it's going to be important how he sets the tone early on. And for me, he's going to be a big, those guys are going to be two big players for the national team in the World Cup.
Yeah. Something I want to ask you as someone who, let me just put something to you. I remember that World Cup with Namibia, right? Mm. Where David Wisa went to play for them. That's somebody you know quite well as a South African. Mm. And maybe would have played alongside David Wisa. He went to play for them, and you could just see his impact on the team in that World Cup. Do you suspect that Corey Anderson will have that same sort of impact on this US team for the World Cup?
Yeah, 100%. I mean, he comes with a lot of experience. He's a good team man. I'm having spent some time with him here in the US. He's a very good team man. He'll pass on a lot of valuable information that guys could latch onto. So that's going to be really good. And that for me is an important part of the game, you know, with guys that can handle or bring this experience, it sort of passes on and gives the other guys this calm nature that they after, you know. And I mean, for that, it's really important in a big competition, which he has been a part of too. It's going to be the first World Cup for many of these guys. There's going to be a big crowds in. There's going to be big players they're playing against. So it's going to be important that he just passes on all this wealth of knowledge and experience that he has in the game of cricket to the rest of the team. And then they can be calm and just try to replicate what they've been doing for many years.
Yeah. And he has experience of playing a home World Cup 2015. He played that World Cup, joined Australia, New Zealand World Cup. So he has experience of playing home World Cup. He also played the 2014 and 2016 T20 World Cups as well. You know, and New Zealand has always been a powerhouse. He has always been an important part of the team. Mm-hmm. So I suspect that, as you said, that experience that he'll bring and just handling those pressure situations, I think his experience is invaluable to this team.
Yeah, I can agree with you more, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Something I must ask you, though, as someone who has played international cricket, what do you think are the unique strengths?
I think do
you think this US team will bring to this?
The uniqueness of this team is a lot of the players wouldn't have played against a lot of these guys. So talking about India and Pakistan, would never have seen a lot of these guys play. So they're going to have to sort of, you know, learn on the fly. And having played a lot of international cricket, you're playing against guys that you don't quite know. It's kind of difficult, you know, to sort of go around it. You don't know where their strengths are. And as soon as bowlers will bowl, they'll bowl into a sort of strength that the batter likes, and then, you know, they get away with it, and they sort of create momentum. So I think that's going to be a challenge for the powerhouse teams, just to you know, find their feet. And if the T20 format is so short and things can happen so quickly, and another thing that they bring is all the spin bowling options that they do have. It would be nice to have seen a leg spinner in the middle overs. But I think they have three left-arm spinners, which I think is one too many. But they have a lot of good spin bowlers in Nashtush and Harmeet Singh bowl in the middle period, which is really, really good. And then you have guys like Stephen Taylor, who spins the ball away from left-handers. So they've got a lot of options that they can go to, as well as a guy like Shadley van Schalkwyk, who's just recently, you know, made his debut for the US. He bowls a lot of cutters in the middle period, very smart with his options that he goes to. So he will add a lot of valuable knowledge and you know, expertise in the middle overs. So I think they will navigate the middle overs really well. And that for me is the most important thing going forward.
Yeah, as you mentioned, Van Schalkwyk, let me just touch on him and Andreas Gauss. In terms of, you would know them quite well, coming from South Africa.
Yes.
Andreas Gauss is a real power player.
He plays really well in the power plays. Yeah. He can get going. We've seen him in the past. If he gets through the first 5 to 10 balls of his innings, he can really take bowling attacks down. He hits the ball in good areas. He plays the short ball pretty well. And he bats at a good strike rate. So he can put pressure on opposition. And if you get that kind of pressure early on, it puts bowling attacks under pressure. He's really improved against left-arm spin bowling, which was a struggle of his. So that's also helped him in his game. And he will also be a player to watch out for. He's good in the power plays and the top of the order. So that's a great win for the team. And like I just mentioned, Shadley now, he's quite smart. He bowls a lot of slow balls, back of the hand, off cutter, leg cutter. So he's quite smart with the ball in hand, you know. And he's played a lot of first-class cricket back home. So this is a good opportunity for him to, you know, to finally get an opportunity on the international stage and put his hand up and show what he's all about.
Yeah. Let's look at the fact that their opening game is against Canada. Recent 4-0 win over Canada. I guess they would want to set the tone in the tournament.
The 4-0 win against Canada means nothing in that first game, you know. So they've got to know exactly what they're all about. And, you know, this is important because as soon as the rest of the world sees what the US is all about, people are going to see, you know, how they play and what they're all about and what they're going to do. So this is going to be important for them to set the tone and really, really put their hand up and play good cricket. So I'm looking forward to that first game. It's going to be a great game out in Dallas. I think it'll be high scoring. The US have played good cricket now. The key players are hitting form. And it's just important how they just come out and start playing. You know?
Yeah, you have real experience in developing players, you know, as a coach. Where do you see it heading in terms of the development of these players and the impact this T20 World Cup, home T20 World Cup, I would dare say, being hosted by US
the most important
and,
thing
and the West Indies
that people don't really understand is the amount of talent that's coming
and
through.
The whole development
There's a serious amount of talent coming through in the US. And the players that are putting their hands up is big time players, the young players coming through. So that will be a good thing for cricket in the country. If guys are coming through now, putting their hands up, they know exactly that, you know, there's opportunity now on the international stage because they've seen guys play. So this is going to be a really important part of the game. It's going to be exciting just to see these guys get opportunities and really play on the world stage. And the development of the players are going to be good because if they put up a good performance, you never know. You know, they might get in the CPL gig, the SA20, the ILT20. There's so much more cricket around the world. So this is an opportunity for them to put their hands up.
Yeah, because we see that the Major League Cricket, a lot of people saw the Major League Cricket last year, but also the Minor League Cricket that is developing so many players throughout the US, 36 cities.
Yes.
It really will provide that sort of development. And having this sort of tournament in the US, big ICC men's
team. For sure. I mean, having played in the minor league too, and the major league last year, it's really good to see the talent and the continuous talent coming through, you know. So there's an abundance of players that's coming through in the US, and there's loads and loads and loads of talent. So it's going to be important for how the game keeps going in a forward direction. And it's exciting, very, very exciting.
And I hope this will impact the popularity of cricket in the US. I know we have a lot a strong maybe Asian population in the US that loves cricket, but also you'd want to tap into getting more people into cricket and bought into cricket. So I think, I hope it will help with the popularity of the sport to go in the US. Yeah. So in light of the US, let's look at if you should pick one team that you would see as a big contender for the US in the group stages, what team would you pick there?
I think Canada and Ireland is something that they need to eye and win. But I think with you know, this format, you never quite know. There's India and Pakistan too. But I think the big game for me would be the Ireland game for the US. If they can get over the line there, that will give them a lot of confidence going in for the rest of the competition, you know, playing against the big teams. Because Ireland's a test-playing nation too. So if they can beat Ireland, you never quite know. With all the spin that the US have and how the conditions pan out, that's a big opportunity for them to beat them.
Yeah, even though Ireland is a full member nation, US has beaten Ireland before. They just swept the 4-0 of Canada. But what we have to look at is maybe Pakistan. India, we know India, hoping they can, as you said, and as you said, you'd hope that game against India get washed out and be good for the US. But in terms of Pakistan, when we look at Pakistan, we've seen it can be a real strong team at a tournament, but at the same time, they can go bust as well. I'm wondering if the US is looking at that and say, let us apply pressure to this team because they might just be a little bit fragile because they can come into a game fragile.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, it's especially in this format, you know, T20, anything can go. I've said it before, but if it's 50 over cricket, you know, it's a bit longer. You know, the big teams can get into it. But you have literally an hour and 20 minutes to make a play as a batting and bowling team, you know. So this format really can go anyway. And it'll be so important just to see how they start the game. If they start and they bat first and they get 50 for one after the power play. That's the most important part of the game, you know. And if they get through that stage, anything can happen. And like you say, with Pakistan, I still like them as a World Cup team. They've always, you know, they sometimes play well more than they play badly in the World Cups. But I know what you're saying about being bust. But, you know, if they can get in a game early on against them, you never quite know, you know. And World Cups are there. We've seen it in every form of the World Cup, from the Rugby World Cup to the Football World Cup and the Cricket World Cup. There are upsets in every corner, you know. And I mean, team environments are really important. So if the team sticks together, that's what you're going to need on the field, you know, and that will get teams over the line. If you're not really committed to, you know, playing together as a team, then what is the actual point
of when you look at a player like, to play let's look at the powerhouse nation as a leader, Manan Patel, I don't know how well you know him. I guess he would have worked as a captain because you need that sort of leader. If you are to pull off the unexpected. What do you think about him as a captain?
Yeah, I mean, he's a quiet guy in general. Doesn't speak much, but he tries to lead with action. And that's what he's going to try and do. You know, he's going to try and come and play up front, open the batting, try to put pressure on the opposition. He's quite aggressive with his batting style, plays spin really well. So he's going to try and do it, you know. A lot of these guys are getting built up because they were born in India. Some of them born in the US, but from Indian heritage. So they're going to try and get themselves going for the India game. But it's all about him providing the calmness in the environment and not getting ahead of themselves. So he's quite calm in how he approaches things. It's going to be exciting just to see how things unravel, you know.
Yeah. And with the pieces around him, the likes of Vice Captain Jones and, you know, as you said, Stephen Taylor and so on around him, I guess these, if things click, they should do well. But in terms of some of those players, if you should maybe pick a player who is not necessarily so known, well known, but who you expect to break out in this World Cup, who would that player be?
Nostush Kenjige. I mean, for me, he would have another breakout season. I know he did pretty well in the MINY team last year in the Major League. I think this is going to be a big tournament for him. I like, he's such a power punched cricketer. He bowls well, he's good in the field. He bowls pressure overs too in the power play. That's going to be important, you know, how they start. And he's put his hand up and he's done pretty well with the ball in hand. So he's going to be so important with how he goes about bowling for them. So I think he's going to be a guy that you could be out there to you know, really watch with keen interest.
Let me put you on the spot.
Yes, I do. I mean, there's a possibility.
DC,
with everything, you know. I would like to see after the first couple of games, I know that's but sitting on the fence, but just to see how they go about it and handle the pressure. If they get their first game out of the way, just to see the momentum and the makeup of their team, that's going to be important just to see how they do things. I think there's always a possibility. You know, this format of the game, if it was any other format, 50 over, I would have probably said no, but this format of the game, anything can happen. So, there's always a possibility, to be honest.
Yeah, and I must close out with asking you, what would your message be like to the fans, to the fans supporting the US team for the World Cup?
I mean, it's what I said all the time. You know, they're going to go out there and they're going to try to put their best foot forward. They never go out with a purpose to fail. So they're going to go out there trying to put their best foot forward and try to play the best cricket that they possibly can, you know. For me, it's going to be important how they start the competition. I'll say this over and over again. If they start really well, then they're good for the rest of the competition, because they're going to be a lot of nerves. It's the first, for every one of them, besides Corey, it'll be their first World Cup game. So they're going to be out there thinking, listen, I need to put my hand up and play really good cricket in order to start the competition well. So just keep supporting them regardless. Go out in numbers, get buy the tickets and go out and really try and support them as much as you can.
All right. I guess the fans will hear you loud and clear, and I know they will go out and support. Here ends our first segment, let me put it that way, our World Cup, US World Cup analysis segment. And I'm really impressed by what we're hearing about this US team and what they can do.